Hello students, in this video you are going to learn about the second rule of converting the direct speech into indirect speech. So we have been learning about the types of speeches only, that is direct speech and indirect speech, am I right? So in the previous video we have learned the first rule, that is the changes in pronouns. Now we are going to learn about the second rule, that is changes in tenses. While converting the speech from direct to indirect, what kind of changes would happen to the tenses, to the verbs? Okay, so let's learn about the changes in tenses. So there are five rules to change the tenses in the indirect speech. Okay, whether this direct speech, in the direct speech the repose, if the report speech comes with this type of tenses, mean this should be converted into this type of tenses only. That they have been giving us five rules only. So in this video you are going to learn only the first two tenses. Okay, what if the report speech comes with this type of tenses, so what we need to do, what are the changes will happen to the indirect speech. Okay, will happen to the verbs which comes in the indirect speech. Okay, so let's learn one by one. First one, if the reported speech or the speech which is inside the quoted marks, inside the inverted commas, if they are in simple present, okay, if they are in simple present, means that should be changed in simple past in the indirect speech. Are you clear, children? When you find simple present in the inverted comma speech, in the quoted mark speech, that simple present verb should be changed to the simple past when we are writing the in the indirect speech. Clear? Let's learn with example. See, here I have written one example for direct speech. In the direct speech, the example is, she said I am happy. She said I am happy. Here you need to notice to the speech which is given inside the commas, inside the inverted commas, that is I am happy. I am happy. I'll tell you about this this reported verb. This is reported verb and this is reported speech. Okay, the speech or the sentences which are written inside the commas, inside the inverted commas or inside the quotation mark, are called as reported speech only. And the verb which is given after the speaker name, that is she is the speaker, next to that said, is the reported verb only. You need to check whether this in the reported speech, inside the quoted mark, there is a simple present or which kind of tense is present inside the speech, inside the reported speech. So here I can find that after I only, we can after the subject only can find the verb, am I right? So here I can find the verb, that is am is the present tense verb only. So here only we are going to make the changes, only. And already said, it is in the past only, so we are not going to change this verb. Okay, always this will come as it is only. Okay, so what are the changes we need to do now? Only in place of am, we are going to change it into the past verb only. Okay, here only we are going to convert this am into past. See, now the sentence will be in indirect speech, will be like, she is the speaker, so that will come as it is. Said is the introduction speech, right? That we should be written as it is. Then in place of this comma and inverted comma, in place of this comma and quotation mark, we need to write the conjunction word, that is a basic rule. And then I should not write pronoun in the indirect speech. What should I do? I need to change this pronoun. This is the first person pronoun. So what do we learn in the previous video? The first person pronoun should be changed to the third person pronoun according to the subject. Here the subject referred to the she only. She will be the third person. So she, I can write the pronoun like she by using the she only. If there is a girl name also, I need to change it into she only. That is the third person pronoun. So she and am will become into the past. that is was. What is the past form of am? Very good, that is was only, and that verb, the main verb will come as it is only, okay. I am happy, okay, this is the adjective, I'm sorry. So I am happy will come as it is. So she said that I will change it into she, and then this simple present verb will change it into simple past, that is was, and then whatever word is given after the verb will come as it is only. And we need to remove this quotation mark at the end, we need to put only the full stop. Are you clear, Sushant? So what are the things we have made change, what are the things we have changed in the indirect speech? We have removed this quotation mark and comma. In place of this quotation and comma, we need to write that, and then we should not write the first person pronoun. This first person pronoun will automatically change it into third person pronoun based on the subject, and then this am will be converted into was, okay. This am will be converted into past, that is was, and the all other word will come as it is. Clear? Why do we need to change this pronoun? Because she said I am happy means our son.
Comes with the present continuous verb, that is
is verb plus ing, are verb plus ing, or am verb plus ing, am I right? Is writing, are writing, or am writing. So the word, if the, that is continuous means ing, the verb will come with ing only. If the reported speech comes with the present continuous means, that present continuous should be changed into the past continuous. That is playing will be was playing, are playing will be were playing, am playing will be changed into was playing. Clear? So let's learn with the example. Here they have given the direct speech, that is Raju said I am playing the guitar. Raju said I am playing the guitar. Raju sonna now guitar vasikiren, vasithu kondirikiren, guitar vasithu kondirikiren endru Raju sonnan. Idhu da actually Tamil meaning of this sentence. Okay, now I need to convert this direct speech into the indirect. So what are the thing I need to do? You know already, because we have already done the first rule. So second rule also same method only. In the indirect, the speaker name will come as it is, said will come as it is. In place of comma and quotation mark, we need to write that. And then here they have given first person pronoun. This first person pronoun should be changed according to the subject. Here the subject is Raju, means one boy. In the third person pronoun, which pronoun refer to one boy? That is he. So I need to write he. Now am playing is the present continuous verb. Am playing is the present continuous verb. That should be changed into past continuous verb. So what is the past form of am playing? Am, what is the past form of am? That is was only. So am playing will be changed into was playing. Was playing and all other words, that is the guitar will come as it is, and we need to put full stop at the end. Clear? So the answer is like Raju said that he was playing the guitar. Raju sonna amar guitar vasithu kondirna appdi nam vasithu kondirka guitar vandu vasithu kondirka endru Raju vandu sonna appdi nam solluvom. Clear children? If you are still collapsing means I have written already one more example. We need to do this one more example. If we do now means it will be very clear for us. See, one more example, that is Pavi said we are going. Pavi said we are going. So in the indirect, we need to write the speaker name as it is, that is Pavi. Said will come as it is, Pavi said, and we need to remove the comma and inverted comma. In place of that we need to write that. And now here, that is the first person pronoun, we is the first person pronoun. So according to the subject we need to change. We means we in third person, which we need to say. So naangal appdin solranga. So which plural pronoun in the third person will be suitable for this we? Yes, that is they only. So Pavi said they. And what is the past form of are? That is where. They were going. Pavi said that they were going. The past form of are going, are will be where only. So are going will be converted into were going. So very simple children. In the first rule you need to change the simple present verb into simple past, that is am or is are will become into was, where will be was where, or go will become went. If you know the past verb, if you know the verbs, the simple present verb and simple past verb means, that will also very easy for you. In the present continuous, that is plus verb plus ing will change into was plus verb plus ing. Are plus verb plus ing will be converted into were plus verb plus ing only. So I hope you are clear with this topic, children. I'll meet you in the next video with the two more rules about the changes in tenses. Thank you.